Welcome back to the IBFP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Welcome back, fight fans. Welcome back. Tyson Fury cheated in the Deontay Wilder rematch. Let's just break it down. You know, there's been a lot of speculation going on. Did Tyson Fury cheat in the Deontay Wilder rematch? People are complaining about the gloves that he wore, about the tape on his gloves, about, you know, whether the Nevada State Athletic Commission even checked his gloves. So there's a lot going on in what people believe. So we got to be honest and unbiased, and let's just break it down, the false from the truth, you know, the facts from the fiction, and let's just dig into it. And, you know, we start, you know, with Tyson Fury's gloves. And, you know, everybody said that, you know, he got away with one. His gloves were laced. His gloves, you know, he cheated. You know, his hand wasn't right. He took the padding out. There's a ton of different things that people are saying about this. And you know what? The first part is debunked 100%. Because as you see here on your screen, that Tyson Fury's gloves were checked by the Nevada State Athletic Commission. Period. That is absolutely debunked. The argument is dead. The argument is done. There's nothing else to talk about. His gloves were checked and signed off on. So what are we talking about? You never question anybody else's gloves. But for Tyson Fury, because Deontay Wilder got the dog shit beat out of him, people are questioning it. People are not believing that the Nevada State Athletic Commission would question that. And this is the funny thing. Everybody always says, you know, Tyson Fury's cheating. Tyson Fury's cheating. What sense does that make when we're in America for this fight? This was Deontay Wilder's soil, his home soil, his home turf. So if you don't remember, you know, all the judges for this fight were American. The referee for the fight was an American. In the last fight with Tyson Fury, Deontay Wilder got gifted a draw when everyone clearly saw he lost. So if we got to be honest and unbiased, people making this whole big stink about Tyson Fury's gloves, it's been absolutely debunked because they were checked by the Nevada State Athletic Commission. Let's be honest and unbiased. And then, you know, people are saying, oh, you know, it was the red tape, it was the blue tape. And, you know, I'm going to just stop and debunk all that controversy altogether. The red tape was from the first fight. That makes no sense. It was from the first fight. So, you know, that happened on December 1st, 2018. February 22nd, 2020, Tyson Fury had white tape. See, these guys don't want to be honest and unbiased. They want to make up all these agendas and narratives and lanes so they can push this nonsense and idiocy. You know, we got to be real about what's going on. And then, you know, you also see barbershop delusional conversation. No wonder this guy got slapped by Kenny Porter. No wonder Kenny Porter slapped this man upside his head, because he's speaking nonsense. He's pushing a narrative. This is a dude that went to go cry after Deontay Wilder got beat like a dog in that fight. And then let me explain this to you. Because this dude actually is calling and having subscribers call the Nevada State Athletic Commission about Tyson Fury supposedly cheating Deontay Wilder. First of all, why would anybody need to cheat Deontay Wilder when he schooled him the first time and got robbed? Deontay Wilder and the fix was in on the second fight. Did you not see the referee giving Deontay Wilder extended periods of time? Did you not see that all the refs, the ref and the judges were all American in favor of Deontay Wilder? This is his home soil. They fought in America, not the UK. So if the fix was in for Deontay Wilder, but people are so desperate to push and reach for a narrative that they want to blame a different reason. They want to blame Tyson Fury. And you know what? Deontay Wilder's an absolute hypocrite. You know, he makes tons of excuses about the suit, as to why he lost this fight. And that's just to name one. But he named tons of excuses. And, you know, this is something that Deontay Wilder said back in 2015 in regards to, you know, Bermain Stiverne being a sore loser about this fight. And this is what Deontay Wilder said, and I quote, "I tell people all the time before I fight them, I let the fighters know, I let the fans know, don't make excuses for my win when I win." They did just that. Everybody's going to have an excuse. The thing about it is, nobody wants to hear an excuse once you lose. When you lose, you lose. Deal with it. And that's what all these Deontay Wilder fanboys and Deontay Wilder himself need to do, is deal with the loss. You got schooled. You got beat. You got destroyed by Tyson Fury, a guy who you said was a pillow puncher. But then those pillows put you down. Let's be honest and unbiased. And then, you know, you see Tyson Fury, he does the right thing because, you know, let me explain to you why Tyson Fury doesn't make excuses. Simply because Tyson Fury made adjustments in the rematch. And simply because, you know, they offered Tyson Fury a water bottle during the post-fight press conference. He refused it because he was concerned it may have been spiked because he knew he had a drug test. So had he failed the drug test and he drank that water, no one would have believed him. No one would have believed him. So that's why you turn things down to prevent things from happening. You don't take chances because you're responsible for everything you put in your body. At the end of the day, his gloves were checked. These guys are making excuses and not taking responsibilities for the loss that they took. Once again, unbiased as always, it's the IBFP.